Session 58 of Unit 5 of Taxation of 5th Semester BBA of Mangalore University. In this session, we shall study the need for tax planning. Learning objective is to understand the need for tax planning. Students should be able to understand why tax planning is necessary. Need for tax planning. In the previous session, we have studied tax planning, tax evasion, tax avoidance, and tax management. Need for tax planning. Reduction in tax liability, minimization of litigation, productive investment, reduction in cost, healthy growth of economy, and employment generation. Reduction in tax liability. The basic need of tax planning is to reduce the tax liability so that enough surplus out of profits remains with the earner of it for his personal and social needs and also for future investments in his business. This is only possible by planning his tax affairs properly and availing the deductions, exemptions, and reliefs. He can succeed in doing so by updating his knowledge about the various concessions available in the taxation laws and the conditions to be fulfilled to avail them. Minimization of litigation. There is always a tug of war between taxpayers and the tax administrators. The taxpayers try their best to pay the least tax and the tax administrators attempt to extract the maximum. Sometimes this results in prolonged litigation. The main reason of litigation lies in tax avoidance and not in tax planning. Whenever a taxpayer wants to reduce his tax liability by finding a loophole in the act, and the tax administrator does not agree with the interpretation of the SSC under which he is demanding exemption, deduction, or relief, it results in litigation. A good tax planning is always based on clear words of the statute or in conformity with the provisions of the taxation in law. In such a case, the chances of litigation are minimized. The third one is productive investment. A proper tax planning brings fiscal discipline in the functioning of a taxpayer and reduces the transfer of money from the person who has earned it by hard labor to the government for waste. The amount so saved enhances the capacity of the taxpayer for expansion and growth, which in turn increases the tax revenue of the government. Reduction in cost. Incidence of tax, which may be direct tax or indirect tax, forms a part of cost of production. The reduction of tax by tax planning reduces the overall cost. It results in more sale, more profit, and more tax revenue. Healthy growth of economy. The growth of a nation's economy depends upon the growth of its citizens. Savings through tax planning devices foster the growth of economy, while savings through tax evasion lead to generation of black money, and the evils of which are clear. Employment generation. The amount saved by tax planning is generally invested in commencement of new undertakings or expansion of the business. This creates new employment opportunities in the business. Further, the taxation laws are so complicated that by and large taxpayers cannot plan their affairs efficiently. Such persons need services of chartered accountants, financial advisors, and lawyers. Such persons join the business concerns either as employees or provide the services as private professionals. Thus, Tax planning is not only the need of the taxpayers, but also of the society as a whole and of the government. References.